Okay. See, now I'm telling you different names for this theory. See, the main name of this theory, that is Peter Drucker's theory. This theory is also called as MBO theory, that is management by objective. This theory is introduced by Peter Drucker in 1954. This theory is also called as C, management by objective, management by participation, management by result, and also goal management theory. See how many names are there for the same theory. The first is Peter Drucker theory, second is management by objective, the third is management by participation, the fourth one is management by result, and the fifth one is goal management theory, and the main name, that is Peter Drucker's theory. See, so many names are there for the same theory, and the examination, they can consider any name for this theory. Okay, so please keep in your mind different names of the same theory, isn't it? See, the basically here, the main name, this is the Peter Drucker's theory, but this is also known as the famous name of this theory, that is MBO. MBO means what? Management by objective. See, the name itself describe more, that is here the objective, that is nothing but, see, most of the time what we are saying, the objectives and goals. So objectives are the steps to achieve the particular goal, but here according to the Peter Drucker, both are same. There is no difference between the goals and objective, but the difference is only the short-term objective or the short-term goals, or the long-term objective or the and the long-term goals. That is only the difference. There is no difference between the goal and objective, isn't it? Both are same according to the Peter Drucker. So here in this MBO theory, the Peter Drucker is saying that this is MBO, it is a process. See, I'm repeating this word, that it is a process. The process of what? Process of setting of the objective. See, process of setting of the objective. So here, who set the objective? Just recall the another name for the same theory, that was the management by participation. See, management by participation. So here, so whatever objectives are there, the set of objectives are determined by managers and the subordinates. That's the reason this theory is also called as management by participation, isn't it? Understood about this? Yes? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So MBA, it is a process. Why it is a process? It is a process of determination of the set of objective, and these objectives, they are determined by managers and the subordinates. In short, you can say, so whoever the part of that institution or organization, they indirectly involve in the setting of the objective. That's the reason this theory is also called as management by participation. Okay, we'll take one example. Suppose objective is, see, the objective, we are talking, we are considering any school, and the objective of the school is achieving 100% results of the 10th standard students. Okay, the objective is achieving 100% result of the 10th standard student. Okay, so 10th ki jo bhi students hai unka result kitna hona chahiye? 100%. Ye kya hai? Target kiya hai. So these are the set of objective, these are nothing but the targets. Aapka ye target hai. So to achieve the target, so what you will see, now it's your turn, you have to tell me, suppose your objective is, see, this objective is laid by or the determined by all level managers, means here we can say the in terms of school, you can say principal and the teachers. Okay, together they have decided this objective, that is in this academic year there will get 100% result of the 10th standard student. Okay, so that is the objective. So for achievement of that objective, as a teacher, what you will do? Yes, tell me. What you will do for the achievement of this objective? Bataiye aap mujhe.
As a teacher, we will take their practice as much as we can take.
Yes, you take the drilling, you take the practice. My thing is, yes. I want some other answers. Yes, what you will do? Kya kar sakte ho?
The students who are below average, for them, we can start the extra classes.
Very nice. The students, they are having their below average, they are, we can say, the low achievers. For them, we can start extra classes, or you can say we can start diagnostic and remedial teaching for those students, right? So different strategies as a teacher we can apply. So that is nothing but the action plan. We can take revision of the content. Suppose some subjects are there, like mathematics, these subjects, they need drilling of the subject. वहाँ पे रिवीजन होना बहुत जरूरी है. इवन यू कैन एज अ टीचर यू कैन टेक टेस्ट. अगर आप टेस्ट लोगे तो आपको पता चलेगा कि उनका अचीवमेंट कितना हो रहा है, उनको कितना अंडरस्टैंडिंग हुआ है. सो दैट यू कैन कंटिन्यू द सेम मेथड ऑफ द टीचिंग, और यू कैन रिवाइज योर कंटेंट. वट एवर कंटेंट यू टॉट प्रीवियसली, यू कैन रिवाइज द सेम कंटेंट अगेन. सो डिफरेंट स्ट्रैटेजीज एज अ टीचर यू कैन अप्लाई, बिकॉज योर टारगेट इज यू हैव टू गेट अचीव 100% result of the 10th standard students. See, so what you understood about this Peter Drucker, this theory is called as, I'm repeating this again, the Peter Drucker, the theory is called as management by objective, and the duration is 1909 to 2005. He was a writer, management consultant, and we can say the self-described social ecologist. There are different names for this theory. The management by objective, management by participation, management by result, and goal management theory. This concept of management introduced, or this theory introduced by the Peter Drucker in 1954. Why this theory is called as management by participation? Because here the main is, see, the main name of this theory is Peter Drucker's theory, or the MBO, that is management by objective. But here, set of objectives are determined by the all level managers, or you can say managers and the subordinates together. So here, these objectives, they are nothing but the targets. Targets decided by the particular objective by taking help of all level managers. Okay. And here we took example that we want to achieve 100% result of the 10th standard. Yahan tak aapko samajh mein aaya? You understood till here? Yes. Yes or no? Hello? Hello, my voice is audible or not?
Yes, ma'am. Audible.
Okay, understood about this? This is a brief introduction about the Peter Drucker's theory. Okay, now we will start the main thing. We can say three things are important. Important here. Okay. The things are see identification of goal, the second is individual workers. Individual workers' responsibility is fixed. See, second is individual workers' responsibility is fixed, and third is guidelines are given to achieve the goals. Guidelines are given to achieve the goals. Okay, see, in this theory, we are just now we are focused on the basic introduction about the Peter Drucker's theory. In this theory, there are three things which are important: identification of goal, the second is individual workers' responsibility is fixed, and third is guidelines are given to achieve the goals. Okay, so here identification of goal, initially we took example of 10th standard result. So here that can be identification of goal. Goal can be, it can be short term, it can be long term, it depends. See, in neighbor differentiate between goals and objective. See, to achieve for the achievement of goal, there are we have to let certain objective. See here, the goals and objective. According to him, goals and objective are same. So first, we have to identify our goal, and these goals are nothing but our target. This is our target. Okay. The second is individual worker's responsibility is fixed. See here, who determined the objectives, or you can say who identified the goals? As we know, this theory is also called as management by participation. Means here, everyone, higher level manager, even subordinates, they have decided or determined the goal. They have identified the goal of that institution. Okay, so here, individual workers' responsibility is fixed. See, means for the achievement of the goal, everyone should participate in the achievement of the goal. And here, to fix each one's responsibility, action plan is prepared. Okay, so there is an action plan who decide the responsibility of every worker who is part of that institution or organization, isn't it? Then the third is guidelines are given to achieve the goal. So here it is decided that the higher level manager should give proper guidelines to the lower level manager so that it will be easy to achieve the goal. So these basic three things are here which are very important about this theory. The first is identification of goal. Then the, as we can see, responsibility means assignment of the task as well as the responsibility. It is fixed. And in the third, higher level manager should guide the lower level manager. Understood the basic three things in this Peter Drucker's theory? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then we move towards the next point. Okay. This is nothing but the process. If we see the process. The process of MBO, we can say the process involved in MBO or processes involved in MBO. Processes involved in MBO. MBO means what? Just tell me, MBO means what?
Management
base.
Yes, very true. Management by objective. See, if we see, why it is called as process? What is meaning of process? Yes, tell me what do you mean by process? Aapko jo bhi samajh mein aata hai bataiye, lekin batane ki koshish to kijiye, kyunki koshish karne walon ki kabhi haar nahi hoti. Chalo bataiye.
Process is procedure.
Kya rehta hai procedure mein?
Different actions to be taken to achieve the goal.
Different actions.
Process
is mean there are certain steps, and we are following the second step after completion of the one step. You are moving towards the third step after completion of the second. That's the reason. And after completion of the final step, again we are coming to the first step. That is nothing but the process. See, what comes under the processes involved in MBO? So as you all know, there are different names, and the main focus is given on the goals and objective. Okay, see, the process, the first is goal setting. The first step in this Peter Drucker's theory or MBO theory, that is goal setting. First, I will enlist all the names of involved in all the steps in the processes. Okay, the first is goal setting. Then second is program planning. Then third is participation. Fourth is development and implement. Fifth is motivation. Sixth is control. Seventh is feedback. And the last step in the process of the Peters-Ruckers theory, or you can say in MBO, that is compensation. So these are the in the process, we can say these are nothing but the different steps involved in the processes of MBO. Okay, so we'll start with the first step, that is goal setting. As you all know, this theory is also called as management by objective, management by goal. So first we have to decide the goal, and these goals are nothing but the target. Okay, so here, so what Peter Drucker is doing, first we have to decide the goal. Okay, so goal, it can be short term, it can be long term. For example, suppose we are saying that all students, they will all be students in the second year B.Ed, they will get pass, they should pass in the final examination. So this is a short term goal. And so whenever we are talking about the quality education in the particular teacher education institution, that can be a long term goal. So first we have to decide the goal, and who will decide the goal of the particular institution? Yes, tell me. Yes, who will decide goal in that particular institution?
Management.
No. See, here we have another name for the Peter Drucker's theory, that is management by participation. So here we are talking about the management. The first thing,
student.
See, all level managers, they are coming together and they are determining, they are deciding the goal. यहाँ पे क्या होगा, अगर आपको कोई goal decide करना है, तो यहाँ पे principal, teachers, non-teaching, they will come together and they will decide the goal. ठीक है? ये क्या रहेगा, गोल डिसीजन रहेगा. किसने लिया रहेगा? सभी ने एक साथ आके लिया रहेगा ये डिसीजन. सी दैट इज नथिंग बट द गोल सेटिंग. इट कैन बी लॉन्ग टर्म, इट कैन बी शॉर्ट टर्म. सो हियर वी टुक एग्जांपल. सो ऑल स्टूडेंट्स दे विल गेट फर्स्ट क्लास इन द फाइनल एग्जामिनेशन. दैट कैन बी फॉर द पर्टिकुलर स्टैंडर्ड. फॉर द 10th स्टैंडर्ड वी विल टेक एग्जांपल ऑफ फर्स्ट ईयर बीएड और द सेकंड ईयर बीएड. दैट इज नथिंग बट द शॉर्ट टर्म गोल. And the long-term goal, that is quality education, that is nothing but the long-term goal. Or you can say all-round development, that can be also long-term goal. Okay. The next is the program. Understood about the goal setting? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Then program planning means what? See, we have decided the goal. See, before when I ask you about the, if your target is this, so what you will do for the achievement of the particular target? So there should be a planning, there should be planning of action. आप क्या action लेने वाले, your target is this. अगर आपको बताया जाता है कि आपका ये target है. See, suppose you have decided your own target. आप ये, आपका ये target है कि मुझे Pune University का gold medalist होना है. अगर आप B.Ed में हो और आपने ये target decide किया है कि आपको Pune University का gold medalist होना है, आपका target है. लेकिन यहाँ पे target ये किसने decide किया है? आप खुद ने डिसाइड किया. बट हियर एज अ पार्ट ऑफ पर्टिकुलर इंस्टीट्यूशन, सो ऑल वर्कर्स और यू कैन से एम्प्लॉयर एंड एम्प्लॉई, दे कम टुगेदर एंड दे डिसाइड द गोल. लेकिन अगर गोल डिसाइड किया, वहां पे काम खत्म नहीं हो जाता. बिकॉज फॉर द अचीवमेंट ऑफ द गोल, आपने गोल डिसाइड किया क्योंकि आपको एक पाथ आपने ये डिसाइड किया है. सो आप वहां तक जाओगे, तो वहां तक जाने के लिए आपको कुछ तो चाहिए. सो दिस प्रोग्राम प्लानिंग इज नथिंग बट द वे, that is nothing but the action plan, जो आपको help करेगा कि कहाँ किसमें help करेगा, for the achievement of the goal. So this program planning is nothing but the action plan. See, if we see every school is preparing their annual plan. That annual planning is nothing but the action planning. Okay, that is the second step which comes under the processes in MBO. That is program planning. Simply we can say the plan of action to achieve the predetermined goal. Of course, that is the first step. So here we are planning. See, the plan of action is to achieve the predetermined goals. Understood about this? Yes or no?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next is participation. See, this theory is also called as management by participation. So here participation is where? Participation is in the goal setting, and even for the completion of the target, there should be participation of each and everyone should be needed. Okay, so यहाँ पे गोल सेटिंग में सबने पार्टिसिपेट किया, हमने सबने मिलकर ये गोल तय किया है कि हमारा ये गोल है. हमारा क्या गोल है कि सेकेंड ईयर के सभी स्टूडेंट्स को डिस्टिंक्शन मिलना या फिर फर्स्ट क्लास और डिस्टिंक्शन मिलना, ये हमारा गोल है. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे हमने उसके लिए उसके अकॉर्डिंगली हमने एक्शन प्लान बना लिया. सो एवरीवन हु इज पार्ट ऑफ दैट इंस्टीट्यूशन हैव टू फॉलो दैट एक्शन प्लान बिकॉज फॉर द अचीवमेंट ऑफ द प्री डिटरमाइंड गोल. बट नाउ अपने एक्शन प्लान बनाया उतना काफी है? नहीं काफी, क्योंकि आपका टारगेट तभी अचीव होगा जब आप उस आप में आपका 100% दोगे, जब आप टीम वर्क करोगे. सो इन द पार्टिसिपेशन एवरीवन हु इज एवरीवन मींस व्हाट, हायर लेवल, मिडल लेवल एंड लोअर लेवल, ऑल लेवल मैनेजर्स शुड पार्टिसिपेट इन द अचीवमेंट ऑफ द गोल. मींस हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द टीम. सो देयर वी हैव टू हियर वी हैव टू वर्क एज अ टीम इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ एमबीओ. Okay, here we'll take one example. Suppose suddenly, और अगर आपको पता चलता है कि कुछ दिन के बाद कोई एक कमेटी आपका स्कूल का असेसमेंट करने के लिए आने वाली है, तो आप क्या करोगे? वहां पे कोई ऐसा ना होगा कि खाली प्रिंसिपल काम करता रहेगा, क्योंकि आपका अगर मीटिंग बुलाई, आपने सबने ये डिसाइड किया नहीं हमें अच्छा ग्रेड चाहिए. सपोज यूर स्कूल इज गोइंग टू असेस बाय द सैक. फॉर द कॉलेज देर इज अ नैक, फॉर द स्कूल देर इज अ सैक, सैक कमिटी यू कैन से. सो हियर there are different criteria. On the basis of criteria, particular committee is going to assess your school. So here, all level managers, you can say the principals, teachers, vice principals, supervisors, they will come together. They will decide that if we want to gain good grade in the assessment. आपको आप क्या decide करोगे कि आपको assessment जब किया जाएगा तो आपको अच्छा grade मिलना चाहिए. It can be A grade. Okay. ये आपका क्या है? सो दैट इज योर गोल सेटिंग, दैट इज योर टारगेट. आपने टारगेट पहले से ही फिक्स किया है. सो यू विल स्टार्ट योर एक्शन प्लानिंग, बट फॉर दैट प्लानिंग यू हैव टू गिव योर 100%. देयर शुड बी टीम वर्क. सो हियर फॉर द फॉर गेटिंग फॉर अचीवमेंट ऑफ द बेस्ट ग्रेड फॉर द इंस्टीट्यूशन, ऑल रिसोर्सेस इन दैट इंस्टीट्यूशन दे वर्क टूगेदर, दे वर्क एज अ टीम. ओके, अंडरस्टूड अबाउट दिस पॉइंट, दैट इज पार्टिसिपेशन? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Okay, good. Then next is development and improvement. ठीक है. See, घर में भी बहुत बार ऐसे होता है कि आप एक कोई भी रेसिपी करते हो, जैसे कि आप पनीर मसाला पनीर आपको बनाना है, आप रेसिपी करते हो, तो वहां पे कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि आपने उसमें मिल्क मिक्स किया और आपको समझ में आया कि आपने मिल्क गलत टाइम पे मिल्क अपने कर में डाला है, तो फाइनली वो मिल्क फट गया. आपको ये समझ में आया? ठीक है, तो नेक्स्ट टाइम आप क्या करोगे कि आपके स्टेक्स में कहीं पे तो कुछ गड़बड़ है, आप क्या करोगे? उसको इम्प्रूव करोगे. नहीं नहीं, यहाँ पे गलत है, इसकी वजह से ये हुआ है, तो हमें ऐसे करके नहीं चलेगा, हमें कुछ चेंजेस करने हैं. सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द डेवलपमेंट एंड इम्प्रूवमेंट. सी, वंस अ प्लान इज ड्राफ्टेड, it is implemented. After planning, there is the next step, that is implementation. Okay, so whenever you found any obstacle in the implementation of the plan, so there is a need of revision of the plan. We have to work on the plan and we have to improve our plan. So here nothing but the development and improvement of the planning. For example, for the achieving of the target 100% result in the SYBED. So that is the target which is determined by the principals and teachers. Okay, so here suppose teachers are using there is annual planning and teachers are teaching as per the annual planning. Teachers are using their own methods of teaching, but still they are not getting good results. I'm not talking about the final result, but in between, if suppose teacher is going to conduct any test, the teacher if she will not get good result, then there is a need to improve her planning of teaching. So for that she might, what she did, suppose unhone kya kiya, unhone wahan pe remedial teaching liya. Remedial teaching wahi pe hoga jahan pe diagnosis hoga. Aapko agar nidhan hi nahi hai hua kya hai wahi pata nahi hai, aap remedial teaching kar paoge nahi kar paoge, sahi hai na? अगर मैं आपको ये पढ़ा रही हूँ, अगर मुझे पता ही नहीं है कि आपको प्रॉब्लम कहाँ पे है, तो अगर मुझे प्रॉब्लम समझ में आएगा तभी उसका मैं सॉल्यूशन निकाल पाऊंगी. सो दैट इज नथिंग बट द डायग्नोस्टिक एंड रेमेडियल टीचिंग. सो हियर देयर इज नीड ऑफ डेवलपमेंट एंड इम्प्रूवमेंट इन द एक्शन प्लानिंग वी कैन से. Isn't it? Understood about this fourth point or the fourth step? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Okay. Now it's your turn. Tell me about the motivation. We already studied this motivation in previous theory also and in the functions of management also. Now it's your turn. Just tell me about the motivation. And you can correlate this motivation with the previous steps.
Encouraging the employee.
Yes, motivation, that is nothing but the encouraging the employee. But here the main thing is there should be continuity, or you can say the constancy in the motivation, or you can say reinforcement. See, because here our target is we have to achieve something more, and that is our goal is maybe it is long term target, or you can say long term goal. So there is a need of continuous motivation. Okay, so here motivation is given by whom? Motivation is given by
teachers
to the
students.
Yes, teachers to the students and from principal to the
teacher.
So in short you can say
teachers.
Yes, how can generalize this? Motivation is given by
higher rank to lowest rank.
Yes, higher level managers to the lower level managers. Okay, see why there is a need of motivation. So suppose aapko kabhi aise experience aaya hai ki aapne kabhi bhi kaun se bhi class mein aapne ek rank liya hai, first, second, third, whatever it is, aur aapko aapke teachers ne ya fir aapke ghar walon ne ya fir aapke padosi ne aapko motivate kiya hai, are aapko to bahut acha rank mila hai, keep it up, आपको शाबाशी दी है, आपकी बहुत प्रेजिंग की है, तो उसका असर क्या हुआ है? आपने ऐसे कहीं हुआ है कि आपने नेक्स्ट टाइम आपका टारगेट आपने बहुत हाई रखा है, आपने वो अचीव किया है? आपको याद है ऐसे कुछ आपके लाइफ में कभी हुआ है?
Yes, ma'am.
क्या हुआ था आपके लाइफ में?
मेरा फर्स्ट रैंक आया था तब हमारे जो टीचर थे उन्होंने हमें कंपोज बॉक्स गिफ्ट दिए थे.
ओके,
जैसे फर्स्ट सेकंड और थर्ड रैंक को मैम ने कंपोज गिफ्ट किया था.
हाँ, तो आपके
और उसकी वजह से जो नेक्स्ट कंपटीशन.
ओके, हाँ
मैम, आवाज आ रहा है?
नहीं नहीं, आवाज नहीं आ रहा है.
हेलो,
हाँ, नाउ यू आर ऑडिबल, प्लीज से. हेलो, यस, नाउ योर वॉइस इज ऑडिबल.
तो मैम हमारे टीचर थे मिसेस भांबुड़, तो वो हमेशा फर्स्ट सेकंड एंड थर्ड रैंक की जो स्टूडेंट उन्हें ऐसे गिफ्ट देते थे जैसे कंपोज बॉक्स ऐसे. तो इसकी वजह से मतलब एजुकेशनल एग्जाम छोड़ के हम बाकी चीजों में भी पार्टिसिपेट करते थे, जैसे अदर स्पीच का एक्टिविटी हो या फिर डांस, तो उसमें हम पार्टिसिपेट करते थे.
Here the role of a teacher, even the role of parents, it is very very important. Okay, अगर आपको motivation मिलता है, see there should be consistency in the motivation. बहुत बार ऐसे होता है ना कि जैसे कि अगर क्लास में टीचर इज शोइंग बायसनेस टुवर्ड्स द स्टूडेंट्स, एक का रैंक आया सिक्स, सपोज थ्री रैंकर्स आर देयर एंड टीचर्स इज ओनली प्रेजिंग फर्स्ट रैंकर, देन क्या होगा? बाकी लोगों को बहुत बुरा लगेगा, मेरा सेकंड रैंक आया, एक मार्क्स से मेरा फर्स्ट रैंक गया है, लेकिन टीचर मुझे अच्छा नहीं बोल रहे, मुझे शाबाशी नहीं दे रहे. सो दैट कैन बी अ डीमोटिवेशन फॉर द स्टूडेंट. So there should be motivation and there should be continuation in the motivation. Understood about the motivation? Okay. And see, in terms of teachers, this motivation, it can be in the form of praise. Yes, you did good job, excellent job, in the form of appraisal, in the form of increments, etc. Okay. So this is about the motivation. The next is controlling. See, control, to control. So someone should be there who have control over the subordinates. So of course, so here we are talking about the higher level managers. Higher level managers should have control over the lower level managers. See, because here what we are doing, we are implementing whatever action plan we made in the second step, this program planning. Okay, so as the action plan is going very smoothly, so someone should be there who have control on the lower level managers. So here the principal should have control on the teachers, isn't it? So in the functions of management, we took example that sudden visit of the principal. So whether particular teachers or all the teachers that are teaching appropriately in their classes. So that can be an example of the controlling, isn't it? Understood about the controlling? We have studied this earlier.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next is feedback. See, feedback, it is very, very important. Feedback ki zarurat kya hai? Koi mujhe batayega?
For improvement.
Very nice. For improvement, only for the improvement?
No, our progress toward our objective.
Yes, see. Feedback
to know the service what we are rendering.
Observe the drawback.
See, feedback. In the first year, aapko jab, see, your BL started with micro-teaching, and from micro-teaching till the internship, we are giving you the feedback. As a teacher educators, continuously we are giving you feedback. So there is a teach, there is a reteach, and continuously the teacher educators, they are giving you feedback. If you see, there are columns. The columns are qualitative remark and the column of the improvement. So in the feedback, you have to observe both the things, the good thing as well as things for the improvement. So here the feedback, suppose here we are talking about the quality of the teacher. So to know the quality of the teacher, so first we have to take how the particular teacher or she is teaching in the classroom. So here we have to take feedback from the students, isn't it? So yahan pe feedback kisse kisse liye ja sakte hain? Yes, if you are talking about the teachers. किस किस से फीडबैक लिए जा सकते हैं बताओ आप मुझे. Am I audible to all? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Pardon, please, ma'am.
See, here we are talking about the second last steps involved in the processes in MBO. So here we are talking about the feedback. So from whom we can take feedback?
From students, ma'am.
See, if you are considering teachers. So for the assessing teachers, we can take feedback from the students. Even we can take feedback from colleagues, teachers, colleagues, right? And even principal also, he can give feedback about the work of the teacher. अभी मुझे याद आया. See, in our MIT institution, so the teacher's feedback is taken. So there were three steps. We'll get gradation the points on the from 10 out of 10 we'll get points. So 5 points for the students' feedback, 2.5 points for the colleagues' feedback, and 2.5 points for the principal feedbacks, and total sum total was out of 10. So on the basis of that, increments were given to us. So that is one criteria of the feedback. It can be done by the management, it can be done, you see, management means principal, you can say, or higher authority, you can say. It can be done by the colleagues, it can be done by the, it depends on what kind of target is there. As for that target, the feedback is given or feedback is taken, isn't it? Understood about the feedback? Yes or no? Yes or
yes.
No?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then the last point is, that is compensation. So compensation means, see, after evaluation, the lower level managers who have performed well are given on incentives or stipend for his job done well. Agar unhone acha kaam kiya hai, aapka agar target achieve hua hai, so here the stipend, or you can say the incentives, should be given to the lower level managers. Okay, so that is nothing but the compensations. So here we have studied about the 8 steps, you can say, or the processes involved in MBO. Goal setting, then the program planning, then the participation. Here everyone should be participation for the achievement of the target, that is nothing but the goal. Then there is a development and improvement in the action planning, or you can say plan of action. There should be motivation. It can be by praising, it can be praising words, it can be in the form of money, it can be in the form of increments. There should be control by the higher level authority on the lower level authority. The feedbacks are given to check the progress of the action planning, we can say, or the target, whatever target we have achieved. So for that, feedback is needed. And finally, if the targets are achieved or after evaluation, the incentives or stipends are given if the particular employee, he did his job very well. So these are the, we can say, the steps or this process is involving MBO. And the third is, see, So whatever processes are here, we can convert this, all these, see how many process steps are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, total 8 steps are there. So whatever processes, these are nothing but the steps. But all these processes or 8 steps, we can convert in the 3 steps only. See, the steps are, as you all know, the first step is only 3 steps you can convert. The first is setting of objective. The second step is action planning. You can say action plan. And the last step, that is performance review. Now setting up objective. So the first step, see, that is goal setting, that is nothing but the setting of objective. Then in action planning, these steps comes under these 4 steps: program planning, participation, development and improvement, motivation, and even the control. Everything comes under action planning. So here these 5 steps, they comes together, and then we can combine this sub step in the particular step, that is action planning and performance review. That is nothing but the review. See, I'm very sorry, that controlling, it comes under the last. So first, only first steps, 4 steps, that is program planning to motivation, it comes under the action planning. And in performance review, controlling and the next steps, controlling, feedback and compensation, they comes under the last step, that is performance review. Okay, so here review is taken from time to time, and who will take review? Of course, the higher level manager, he will take review to see or to check if objectives are achieved or not. As for the so for that, he can take SWOT analysis, okay, to check the performance review. So these are the main 3 steps of the Peter Drucker's theory, or the, you can say, the processes involved in MBA, and these are the steps in detail, you can say. So total there are 8 steps, and we can convert all these 8 steps in the 3 steps. See, understood about the Peter Drucker theory? Yes or no? Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See, this is mind map, and this will help you a lot while studying. Okay. So I will share this mind map in our group. Is it okay? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. So if you have any query regarding any point, please ask. If you have any query, please ask. You understood the total topic very clearly? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so should I stop here? This is 3:23 now. Yes, or should I take a small recap of this, whatever we have studied here? See, this is very simple topic. I think there is no need to check whatever you understood, because this is very easy topic. Yes, recap is necessary. Should I summarize this topic again? Please respond. Please respond. आपको समझ में आया है या नहीं? अगर आया है तो ठीक है.
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Understood.
Okay, good. Okay, now I'm going to stop here. After this session, I will share this mind map in our group. Okay. See.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
One task for you. In the second activity, that is the internal assessment. In that activity, there is a second activity. And in the second activity, I have selected seminars and MCQ. Okay, so let me know your interest in which activity. See, seminars, if you are going to conduct seminar regarding this course, as per my experience, it is really good for good scoring. Okay, but MCQ, agar aap MCQ dete ho, aapke study ke upar pura depend hai, aur usme kaise rehta hai, MCQs mein आपके मार्क्स लूज होने के भी चांसेस रहते हैं. सो इट्स योर टर्न नेक्स्ट. अगर आप रेडी हो, इफ यू आर रेडी फॉर द सेमिनार, प्लीज सिलेक्ट योर एनी टॉपिक फ्रॉम यूनिट नंबर 1, 2 एंड 3. फ्रॉम फर्स्ट 3 यूनिट यू कैन सिलेक्ट एनी टॉपिक एंड लेट मी नो इन द नेक्स्ट.
ओके मैम. ओके
ओके
ओके मैम.
Okay, thank you so much. I'm going to stop here. See you in the next session. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, bye-bye.